him?
I'm Cicero.
Cicero?
Yeah.
Questo è 6 anni.
Ecos.
Yeah?
Ecos.
Good morning, everybody. Well, it's like 12 o'clock. So I just got here to Drogheda, and what I'm gonna do today, I'm gonna do this Boyne Valley Camino. It's like a 25k trail leaving from Drogheda and going outside, and I think coming back to the same place, to this west street. There was some church there, I can't remember the name of it. Anyway. I think I'm on the right path now, but I'm not 100% sure, so I'm gonna try and check the map, like which way do I have to go, alright? Enjoy! Alright, yeah, so according to the map, it's like you really have to keep an eye on the map, because there's not many signs. Like sometimes you see like a little yellow sign, but not many. Anyway, still raining. So I try to not to film that much in the beginning, because you know, camera is not really waterproof. And started to leave the town, so hopefully we're gonna end up in some woods or something. So if it's, fuck, it's like hailstones or what the fuck is this? Yeah, all right. Hopefully I get into some woods soon, so you know, I could block the rain and stuff like that. Anyway, hopefully it's gonna clear up. Look at the sky. Okay, let's carry on. Alright, so we have this bridge behind me. Yeah, that one. It's called Mellifont Boyne Cable Bridge. And yeah, I just checked the map. Actually, the rain is stopped for now, and clouds look promising as well. I was just checking the map, and so far I'm still on the right path, just crossing the motorway under this little tunnel here. And yeah, I keep continuing this little walk. Surprising for me, there was no sign in the beginning about, you know, like this is like a Camino Way trail or something. So that was the only thing which I didn't really understand. Oh, I'm in this tunnel now! Alone. Oops, the people are coming and I was just shouting. I think they might think that I'm crazy or something. Could be. Anyway, carry on. So here we have no Angus, we have this yellow sign what we have to follow, and on the map it's actually really cool. Like I was crossing this busy road now, and on the map there is like a warning sign, you know, to keep an eye on crossing busy roads and stuff. So very informative and very cautious map or walk. Yeah, up. I have to be careful not to step into this horse shit, or I presume it's horse shit. Yeah, anyway, we're gonna be in this forest very soon, I guess, and we're gonna pass by an old mill here on the right hand side. At least that's what the map says, so curious to check out that one then. Alright. Yeah, so I'm in this Townley Hall woods, apparently. And it's some sort of big forest. Glenwood, that's the name of this part. And it's lovely. No one here, as always. Only me. Looks really cool. Yeah, I have to walk in this forest for like 1 kilometer. And I'll be on this place called Townley Hall, which is a town, or I don't know what is that, but we will see. It's so cool to only listen to this, like, you know, all sorts of birds and animal sounds. And yeah, only thing I forget, that I didn't bring any sandwiches. So I was hoping that there will be a few shops around or something, or maybe at the end when I get back to Drogheda, then I'll be able to eat something. I might have a sneaky takeaway pint as well, you know. It's 1st of May. Let's celebrate, you know. Okay, just gonna walk ahead and then see what is this Townley Hall when I'm out of this forest. I think I got lost at some point there in the forest, but I was just checking the map of this trail and also Google Maps, and I kind of figured out where I am now. Can I end up on this main road now? And from here, it's not too far to get to this Mellifont Abbey, or I don't know what it's called. We'll find it anyway. This is gonna be a main road walk for a little bit now. And only thing, I have to look for a red brick house, and that's why I'm gonna turn right. So let's look for a red brick house. Not this one though. Another one. You see? This is where I was meant to be coming out from the forest, and not further down somewhere there. Because you see, here are the yellow signs. So I was supposed to come out here and then only walk just a little bit on this busy road. But yeah, I got lost somewhere in the forest. But anyway, it's not that busy and I'm almost at the end of it. I think the next right U-turn is gonna be the where I have to go. Yeah. So I'm a bit worried about the clouds again. Anyway, walking up here now. And I'm like 2 kilometers away from this place called Mellifont Abbey. Some sort of ruins, and the thing about this that on the way there I'll be on the highest point of this whole trail, Camino, and also already nice view. Yeah, so that's the end, or like half of the trail. If I get there, on from there, I'm doing my way back to Drogheda. I just got to this Mellifont Abbey. Few fun facts. So this was the first Cistercian monastery in Ireland. I don't know what is that, but it was the first one. It was founded in 1142, and I think that was the first youth hostel here in Ireland or something like this. And also, the name of this abbey comes from the Latin word Mellifont, which means font of honey. Interesting, right? Okay, let's have a look and check out all the ruins around here and see what we find, yeah?
Hello. Yeah, because I saw you walking, but we were watching. Because
we were
coming down and we were
worried
that
there
might be something.
Right, right. Hi, how are you? Is it like free to come in?
Oh,
or?
Yes, yeah.
Ah, yeah.
We just asked, no climbing.
Oh, yeah, of course. No,
there's information panels around the side.
Yeah, I can see, yeah.
Myself and my colleague are here.
Perfect, thank you so much.
No
like I'm in Pompeii or something, you know, with all these little ruins and everything. It looks really cool. And it's so good to... how's the lights? Yeah, okay. And it's so good to come here, you know, and then there's only like four people here other than me. So it's really cool. Very nice. I really like this place. Oh, this is a nice view from here, look. So Mellifont Abbey, I mean what's left of it. I really like this place, to be honest, and this is also one of those, like, I think, like, hidden gems around Ireland, which you're gonna find in loads of places, you know, because there's loads of historical ruins all over the place, and I bet like loads of people haven't been here before, you know, even though they live not too far from this place, you know. So yeah, definitely worth checking out this place, and now I'm just gonna get out from here and then find a way back to Drogheda, because I have like still like 13 kilometers left to get back. Yeah, follow me on my adventure on the way back. Thank you, I know.
I say about 3 weeks ago,
you stay there, little doggo. Okay, it's update o'clock. Yeah, so just left, you know, the monastery. I'm walking now to Tullyallen village or something like this. Tullyallen. Don't know how to pronounce any of these names. Yeah, it says it's like 1.7 kilometers from here, and there's gonna be some pubs and shops around there. I might get some sandwich or anything, and after that there will be another forest area, and then go down to the river and then get back to Drogheda. nice and cool looking pub with a nice roof, but obviously it's closed, so I can't get a takeaway plan here. Just gonna try to find this supermarket and see what we have there. So I'm after coming out from the centre, which was just a little bit further down there, and bought some stuff, and just gonna have a little picnic here in this village square in front of the pub. Yeah. So I got BLT sandwich, some watermelon triangles, cause why not, and watermelon is good for you. And I also got two cans of Carlsberg and a Powerade. Oh, and I got a scratch card, which we're gonna check out now. I didn't try it, but we didn't win. Anyway, let's do a time lapse here, and till that I'm just gonna eat. Oh shit, we actually did win 2 euro. Just realized before I was throwing it, before I almost throw it out. So I just want 2 euro. Happy days. Alright, after this lovely little lunch, I'm leaving this village now, gonna pass by some church here, and then find a way back into the woods. It's a bit chilly now, so I had to put on my jumper as well, and it feels like it's gonna rain again, hopefully not. Oh my god, this watermelon, BLT sandwich, watermelon, and now I'm gonna open a can of Carlsberg. It's a good recipe. Follow me for more recipes. Let's hope it's not gonna rain. Alright, there's some church here. When you're coming from the village, this is a little gate where you enter this Bernumber woods, and just follow the trail, and at the end we're just going at the edge of it, and at the end is gonna be the obelisk bridge. Can't wait to check that one out. Alright, it's not update o'clock now, it's beer o'clock now. It's Saturday, you know? So why not? Lovely little forest, and yeah, it's like not a hard climb or anything like this. Yeah, but I'm really curious about this obelisk bridge at the end of it, so let's see how is it. It's apparently like 200 years old bridge or something like that. I might just saying a number, you know, don't always believe me. Anyway, let's keep walking on this little forest tracks here and see us at the bridge. Woo. Alright, I think this is the obelisk bridge. And look at this, there is some little... Is it the river? Or I don't know, what is this? Anyway, let's cross the bridge. Wow, very nice view. So what do we know about this bridge? this metal bridge, obelisk bridge, was built in 1868. And yeah, that's all I know about it. So this little canal next to me is called Boyne Canal, and very soon we're gonna cross it as well. And just like loads of fucking cars here. Well, no wonder I'm on the road, but still. Look at the size of this bridge. Impressive and huge. I think this is the motorway up here. That's the crossing, so this bridge is crossing the motorway. I mean, you know what I mean. Yeah, it's huge. When you come this close, that's when you see how big it is. Look at this thing. Very, very, very big bridge. But we shouldn't be stopping just for a bridge, so we carry on. So I think I just made it back to Drogheda, and I just checked, there is a train at 6, it's 5:30, I might make it, and next time I come back and just explore the town as well, because it looks interesting, some interesting buildings and stuff, but not today. I'm hungry, thirsty, no battery, so I'm just gonna go home. Anyway, thank you for coming with me on this little trail. It was amazing, and I'll see you next time. Made it back on the train now, and yeah, I managed to get a few cans on the way home as well, and yeah, it was a lovely day.